I got a project going on in my shop that I think is good content. I think you might be interested. In my shop, I have a 12-inch disc sander. It has a table, obviously, that tilts, right? This project, what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to upgrade the disc sander table, right? And when I'm done with it, I can take the table off the disc sander, put it on a milling machine, and it'll become a mini pallet. I call that dual purpose, right? In order for me to show you what I'm doing, it's going to take, this content is extensive and dictates multiple videos. You understand? I don't know how to configure it. You know, first thing I'm going to do is show you a couple of drawings of what I plan to do, and then the next thing is to go out in the shop and do it. I'm not going to stick it all in one long video, right? I'm going to do them in little videos. You know what I mean? One at a time. So, you know, I'm going to start with number one, the drawings. This is what I'm going to do, guys. Then that'll end that video. Then the next video will be, you know, see what I said? Here's how I'm doing it. That kind of thing. All right? So, anyways. So, it says this content is extensive and dictates multiple videos. In order to help me, right, configure all of this, try this on. This is a recording. Comment, comment, comment. You see the whole thing? Your comments will help me configure the right content that'll make you happy and make me happy. See that on the bottom? Are you getting my drift? Hey guys, here's the subject matter. Disc sander upgrade, alternative mini pallet. Let me tell you something, I'm taking one for the team on this one. I spent too much time on this. My pain is your gain. If you got a disc sander, and I'm talking about a 12-inch disc sander, this content, it's for you. This is an upgrade and you can get a double benefit out of it. Alternative mini pallet. See that there? Let me lay this on you, all right? Here's what the disc sander table looks like. You see it here? 12-inch disc sander, steel table, magnetic. I put that word magnetic in there to let me know or to remind me that I possibly can use some rare earth magnets to position stuff, to hold stuff down, that kind of thing. You understand? Alright? See all them red holes? Them all tapped holes. The steel table is actually cast iron. Right? Just, you know, I know I'm going to get that question. You see it? These blue holes here, these, that's what that table, they got screws in there, flathead screws to screw it down to position the table. You see it? Alright, let me get on with the show. Here's what I'm going to make to go on this sand upgrade or alternative mini pallet. Here's what I'm going to do. You see this? I'm going to make some toe clamps that'll go on it. I want to make a bunch of them. I'm going to give some of them away. Right? You know, an email giveaway. I'm going to, on that pallet, let me get this up. You know what that is? That's a toggle clamp. Right? I'm going to have a couple of that, a few of that style, and I'm going to have one of this style. Let me see. I'm going to have one that's this style here for two different reasons, which I will show you. All right? let me see. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Wait a minute. All right, here's a view of the table, a side view. See it here? See those lines here? That's a slot in the table, right? And we got quarter 20 tapped holes, 18 places, right? Across there, all right? That's for clamping purposes, all right? I'm gonna show you what I can put in there. Hang on. We took a miter gauge from a table saw. Joe Manning rehashed it, did a hell of a job. Let me show what we're gonna do. We're gonna use that in this, on the table, slash mini pallet. You see this? This one here with all cross-section marks is screwed to the left to the miter gauge. This one here is adjustable. It can be adjusted up and down, longer or shorter, depending on what angle you got. I'm gonna see this slot. I don't know if I'm gonna put that in or not, but I put it there to remind me. I'm gonna put this miter gauge on that table. Okay, baby. You can see that this can be, there's a whole lot to look at, but this miter gauge can slide along here, and it can tip, and, we're going to tip it to the left, counterclockwise, right? All right? Now, I don't know if I'm going to use that slot or not because of why. I'm going to show you why. You see this toggle clamp? I can hold it down with this toggle clamp. Watch, I'll show you. Hang on. Position this toggle clamp at an angle. You see it here? So your hand is not near the disc sander, right? You see that? And I can move this toggle clamp in 3/4 of an inch increments all the way across here. So you can see it'll clamp down on that miter gauge there, but I can move it up along here, depending on what's in there, you understand? So that toggle clamp is gonna take care of that problem. I don't know if I want that elongated slot. Hang on, let me see what else I got here. Obviously, I got these. This I could clamp. I'm not gonna bore you with it, but this goes on that table in all kinds of ways, every which way. All right? Now, let me show you something. In order to get that, you see this says here, 250. For that table, I want that slot parallel to that disc grinding wheel. But in order for that table to tip, it needs a gap here. Otherwise, it's gonna need at least 1/4 of an inch gap. How am I gonna get this parallel to that slot? Oh, funny you should ask. I'm gonna show you. These things are called spacer blocks. You see it? Okay, I'm gonna move it onto the, hang on. go in this groove, right? Here's an end view of it. You see it? The sixth end of them will be in the groove, and this part will be laying on the table. What I'll do is I'll put them both in and push this whole table up against the wheel, right? Then I'll tighten these bolts. You see them? Our screws. And that will be, you know, once it's in there, I'll tip it back and take them out. Tip it back on an angle and then take these out. All right? Over here, I got a bunch of other shit I won't show you now, but these are all components that will go in there. Right here's a chamfering jig. You see that? Let me do this. Adjust with this little piece here. These all pivot. I can adjust how deep I chamfer with it. It's called a chamfer jig. I can flip them around, you know? This is a handy dandy little rig, and it'll go right in that groove in the slot that's in the table. I don't know if I'm boring you with this bullshit, but anyway, Then after a while, I'll show you how to make these things. But I'm not going to lay all that shit on you. That's too much in one sitting. All right? All right, guys. I'm going to sign out. You know the routine. Save the world, pay it forward. I can't believe how divided we are. Let's do something. Let's make a difference. All right? Hang on. As usual, thanks for watching. I'll catch you on the flip side.